Welcome, Scratcher.
How are we doing?
I've got a beer from Scotland, from the William Brothers. We purchased it in a Yorkshire bottle shop. Our favourite Yorkshire bottle shop.
Bidhouse.
This is
in Osset.
Yeah, this is their...
They get a few William Brothers, and this is why we managed to get all of this one, and it's their Irish Sun.
Hoppy Golden Ale. We was just looking on Rabia for the information for this beer. And I was just saying to Andrew, it's funny. And he goes, why? And I showed him. It says, on one version, it says bottled only. And then for another version on Rabia, it says cask only, special.
No, seasonal.
Yeah, cask only, seasonal.
And they were both 3.9. And that is a bottled
only. Nice grassy aromas.
It's nice floral.
Wow. Good price. Another reason why we like Beer House is the price on the bottles. £2.15 for a 500ml.
It's quite nice and refreshing.
Scottish ale, 3.9%.
It's quite nice taste. It's like zing on the tongue.
Yeah.
Very nice. Not too watery.
You do get that slight watery aroma. But it is very grassy. It's underneath the session level.
Well, it says here, the Harvest Sun, to slake the first of all the new folk in need of well-earned refreshment, we are proud to present the Harvest Sun, golden in colour, with dry, crisp flavour on sweet, hoppy aroma. Drink chilled with friends.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't mention that much on Ripia or on the industry. It just says overall it's balanced out even.
Yeah, it's not too bad for...
I mean, for the price as
session,
well.
For a session beer.
For some gold nails, we've paid £2.15 for a 330ml bottle and such. But for a 500ml, I mean, it's you get like four or five different sizes. You get the 250, you get the 330, you get the 500. That's just some code.
Is that a batch number as well?
Yeah, there's the on there.
So
it's pretty fresh. And then you get 500 and you get 660 and you get 750 or something like that. Shake it up a bit. Don't do the last bit. Right. It's very lively.
It almost comes off like a lager. Almost slightly.
Yeah, I mean, some golden ales do. It's got a little haziness now. But you still get a lot of that wet dog smell and a little bit of green grass still.
Not too bad.
Lacing.
It's a bit bland sometimes, but it's up. We do get sort of a slight...
You do get like a slight hoppy caramel now, but it's like quite milky, creaminess. It's not watery, but it's like that fluidness. It's nice. It's tasty. For the price, £2.15, it's worth it. It's nice. A few bottles of these is a nice reward after work.
I think. Probably the best in summertime to drink this though,
because
it's nice for a refreshment beer.
And they haven't gone overboard on the labelling, it's just basically, there's the name, there's a little design.
Because, what is it, what cold weather we're getting now, it's like,
because we're in Yorkshire, it's like, I mean, beginning of the week it was rainy, then it was like sunny, then it snowed. And then it was sunny again, and it's raining now.
So enjoying the summertime.
Slight pepperiness there, bit of lemon. Oh, that's a little bit of like nutty aftertaste. That's quite nice.
Pine nuts.
Yeah, like pine nuts. You know those little bit nuts.
Yeah.
What about it? Yeah, I mean, for the price and flavour and the low ABV, it's a great bargain. And
maybe, you know, even try it on Tapper if you see it as well.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure on if it's the same price every bottle shop or what, but $2.15, definitely worth a bargain. One final test. Like, taste it. It's, again, it's not watery. It's like that just bit up, that milky wateriness.
Yeah.
You get a nice fluid flavour. Traditional. You take it.